What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman. Today we're gonna make something like Mario. It's a me, Mario. Except for he does like, it's a me, Mario. All right, never mind. I can't do the Mario voice. Okay, so let me show you this demo. I'm going to run this game. It's loading. All right, so here is the game, and this is sort of like Mario, okay? You have to collect coins and jump. Spacebar is jump. I will leave this demo down the description below so you can try it out. I just made this about 10 minutes ago. Oh no. Yeah, I got that from Crash Bandicoot. You step on things and they blow up. You can see all the mushrooms. If you press shift, you can run faster. I got the bunny from the Easter pack. It's a DLC from Game Guru. Whoa, the grass looks pretty good. Actually, I'm testing this. I haven't even tried this. This is the first run, and it's not too bad. Oh, he fell. The problem was our invisible wall. Okay, so let me just adjust that. I went for an invisible wall. You can only see it here. So let's try this again. Hold shift, run, spacebar is jump. You don't actually have to collect the coins. Like Mario. Oh no, stay away from the porcupine. The porcupine blows up. And then you have to start over. And there's the grass. The grass looks fine. Looks very good, actually. And here's the end of the level. I put a castle there, just to be funny. Okay, so this triggers that level complete. I don't know if you can see it at the bottom there, but if you step on this, you will load the next level. I'm not going to edit the whole level because that took me like 10 minutes to drag all these objects into the screen. But we're going to do the camera like this. Okay, so let me just delete the bunny. And actually, let me save this as something else. I'm waiting for that to save. That likes to save. So let's create a new player start. Okay, I'm going to place it here. I'm going to go to entities and let's find our bunny. Let's see, you can use anything you like actually, but I'm going to use the rabbit because he has a jumping animation. Now to make this a third person, all you have to do is drag this into the player start. Let's run this. Okay, so everything works fine except for you can rotate the camera. Okay, and this looks cool too. There's nothing wrong with this. But we want it to be like, sort of like Mario, okay? Oh, he's going to die. Oh no, the bunny died. I'm gonna go to Steam. Steam. Here is Steam. Steam apps. Common. In Guru. Files. Script bank. Where's my script bank? Script bank. Notice that I always keep in Script bank original in case I mess something up. Let's go to the third person script. Let's open our script. Let me zoom in. So let me set camera override. Oops. Set this to E. Save it. And let's try it out. And you notice that now the mouse is disabled. You can't rotate using the mouse. But he doesn't jump high enough. And the camera is a bit funny. So let's fix that. So let's go to properties and let's change the camera distance to maybe 600. Show reticle, turn it off. Jump speed, let me see, jump speed. Let's set this to 900. Wow, that's super fast. Actually, let me center the bunny a little bit. Okay, so here is the game and wow, we can jump higher now. And we can collect the coins. Now if you press shift, you can run faster. And you can jump higher, I believe. Yeah, coins. Oh no, that is the porcupine. What to do? Wah, wah, wah. He died. So you can see that this is super simple. You can adjust it to your own liking. That's our trigger zone. This loads the next level, whatever you want the next level to be. Now, if you don't know how to do this, check out my other videos. So, and that's it. That's how you can create a Mario game in Game Guru. Share and like the video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.